In this very blue state, one of America's best-known conservative writers paid a visit this week. He is George Will, who's written a column about politics and foreign affairs for The Washington Post and Newsweek twice a week for half a century. He's also a frequent analyst on network television. And he was in Vermont to speak to the Ethan Allen Institute in South Burlington. He gave us a few minutes as well to chat about what he thinks Americans are now hungry for. Mr. Will, thanks for the time.
Glad to be with you.
As we're talking, we don't know the eventual fate of the deal worked out between President Biden and Speaker McCarthy to raise the debt ceiling. But the progressive left thinks it's terrible, and the far right, the Freedom Caucus, think it's terrible. And what does that tell you?
It tells me they probably did something right, which is they've gone down the middle, and when you go down the middle, people get unhappy at the extremes. But it just could be that we're beginning to see little green shoots of compromise come up through the concrete that has suffocated compromise in recent years. First, as you say, the debt ceiling is a compromise. Mr. Biden said he wouldn't negotiate, he negotiated. McCarthy said we want X, Y, and Z, he didn't get all of X, Y, and Z. That's politics. Even on an issue where it's supposed to be unsplittable differences, abortion, you're beginning to see this. Chris Sununu, over in the next door neighbor in New Hampshire, says, I'm pro-choice, and a 15-week ban is fine with me. Glenn Youngkin in Virginia says, I'm pro-life, and a 15-week restriction is all right with me. And by the way, 15 weeks covers about 93% of all the abortions in the United States. So even on the issue that was supposed to resist all forms of compromise, I think we're seeing some.
Still with the new rules that Speaker McCarthy had to agree to become Speaker, you know, he's always on thin ice. I suppose he should make sure his life insurance is paid.
Well, he remembers what happened to Speaker Boehner. Speaker Boehner finally threw up his hands and said, this is like herding cats, I can't do it anymore. This is not an easy job, but too bad. You know, politics is messy.
Is compromise then, it's not a dirty word. It used to be how politics was done all the time in Washington. The famous Tip O'Neill, Ronald Reagan disagree during the day and go out.
Henry Clay was the great compromiser, the compromise of 1820, the compromise of 1850, the Missouri Compromise. Lots of compromises in American history. That's how we keep moving forward.
You're in Vermont speaking to the Ethan Allen Institute folks about conservative values, I think, even in a place like Vermont.
Especially in a place like Vermont.
Okay, how do you make your argument?
Well, first of all, most new ideas are false or injurious or wrong. So stopping things is important if you're going to have a good society. But beyond that, the more I write about American politics from Washington, I've been doing it for 54 years I've been down there, the more convinced I am that ideas no longer trickle down from the top, they bubble up from the bottom. And they bubble up from small, compact, intensely interested state organizations. The Goldwater Institute in Arizona. They're all over the country. There are things like the Ethan Allen Institute, which exist to bring ideas to bear on politics. Politics without ideas has no ballast. And the Ethan Allen Institute's putting ballast in politics here, and I think it's infectious. I think the other 49 states might get infected.
You're in the land of Bernie Sanders.
I understand.
Ben and Jerry.
I understand.
And yet, the Republican governor won in a landslide and is the most popular, is the highest favorable, unfavorable ratio of all 50 states. How can that be?
Well, Larry Hogan, Republican in a very, very blue state of Maryland, very popular. In the bluest of states, Massachusetts, Charlie Baker, Republican, was very popular.
Those are the three.
Exactly. So the American people are not fools, and they like what they like, and they say, well, we'll just compromise. Again, this is your theme. Blue states with red governors, that is a compromise.
So what is it that people are looking for in their leader? Is it, if it's not a D or an R, they'll make an exception if?
I think, and we're going to learn a lot more in 2024, but my supposition is that they're looking for cheerfulness. They're tired of talk about American carnage. They're tired of being against something because the other guy's for something. A lot of people say the American people are angry. I don't believe that. Sure, some people are angry over here and some people are angry over there. But at any given moment in this nation of 332 million people, about 325 million of them are not watching cable television and they're not listening to talk radio. They're raising children and washing the car and fixing the screen window and getting on with life. I think the American people are not angry. They're embarrassed by their politics and they're exhausted by it. And someone in one party or another is going to come along and say, deep breath, everybody. That's what we need, is a deep breath candidate. Deep breath, everybody. Lighten up. Calm down. We've been through civil wars. We've been through depressions. We've been through all kinds of trouble. And we're still on our feet.
Is it going to be Biden, Trump in 24?
Political prophecy is optional folly. And I have an almost pristine record of error in trying to predict the future. So I'll just say this. I wouldn't be surprised if neither of those guys runs. I think there's a not negligible chance that Joe Biden says, I've done enough. I'm a transitional figure. I'm not getting any younger. And I'm going to turn it over to a new generation. That could happen. Remember, Lyndon Johnson was running for president until he wasn't, in late March of a presidential year. And on the Republican side, there's an enormous pent-up desire in the country for something other than a rerun of 2020. And sooner or later, the political market is going to supply what the customers demand. And they're demanding something new.
George Will. Late Thursday, the